Okay, so let's continue now this tutorial on how to locate the cameras or to calculate the vertical illumination using camera in this sports hall. So I googled something about the locations of camera, for example, for the NBA play, and I got this one. So there are some cameras and for the NBA, so this is a professional basketball game. So it has total of 40 cameras. Wow, 40. And these are the locations as per the NBA standards. And look at that. This is cool because the one I mentioned in my previous video is really here. So I just missed this one because on, look at this one, 36 and 37. There is a camera on top of the board of the ring. So yeah, I remember there is something like that. And if you can see, there is number 29 and 17 and 22. You can see there are handheld cameras. And on the top of this is this fixed cameras 1 to 6. So let's go and check the legends of this one. So 1 to 6, these are the hard camera positions. These are the mid-level center court or play-by-play. I'm not familiar with those codes. And then these are the 1 to 6. So you can see it's on the top of what is the sitting area. And if you can see here in the Google, you can maybe just appreciate this by looking at this point of view. Maybe like this one. Okay, because you're looking at the aerial view of the court, something like that. And then this one, those cameras 7 to 10. So these are the low-end cameras, and you can see it's on the side of the court. And then the 11 to 13, these are the high-end. And where is that? 11 to 13. This is the 11 to 13. Okay. Wow. And there is 14, which is high-end zone corner beauty. There are so many things here. And this one, you can see 29 to 34 is the handheld camera positions. So this is flexible and they can move easily on the positions because the person who's the camera is movable because of the person who is handling it. And this one is number 36 to 40 is the unmanned fixed camera. So maybe if you're working with the light for the lighting design for this basketball court for televised or for this sports hall, you need to ask to your client where are the fixed cameras and this handheld cameras because these are the basic. And if they don't know or if they don't have any idea, you can suggest this one. Check this one. Just Google it. It's the camera locations for a basketball court or for the NBA basketball. And yes, and see 36 to 40, these are located here beside the basketball court. One on the top of the ring, at the bottom of the ring, on the sides of the ring. I forgot there is one here, should be on the middle of the court. Yes. So that's it. So what we did on the previous video is just here at side of the ring, near the ring. Maybe we can add more here. So let's go and add one more cameras here. So go to the calculation object and then select the camera tab and place one camera here at the middle of this court. Okay, there you go. This is now the camera number 7. And let's move this one here because it's on the court side of the futsal court. And yeah, I think this is fine. Oh, I forgot. Let's add cameras on the top of the ring. So where it should be? Here it should be. It should be in the ring. And let's rotate it. There you go. And maybe the height. Let's just assume the height of this camera. Like say 3. Let's just make it 4 meters. Sorry. Let's just make it 3.5 meters. I'm not familiar with the height of the ring. Let's go and check in the 3D. Yeah? Perfect. There you go. Okay, so I think I need, oh, look at that. I need to fix it up a little like this. So it should be 4 meters. So I just follow the 3D object of Marcel. So let's just assume like this. All right. So now we have, I think, 8 cameras. And let's see if we achieve all those lux level requirements. Because here in this standard, they did not mention, but actually we can Google it now. All right, so while we are searching for the last level requirement for a vertical in the basketball court or in the sports hall, let's run this calculation now. Okay, so the calculation is done and it looks okay, but we are now getting the 1, 2, 3, yes. So for the basketball court, we have 1,600 lux for the camera number. Which camera is this? Camera number one. Okay, so we got 1,679 lux for camera one. The camera one is on the top of this benches. And if we go and check the standards for the vertical for this sports hall, I check it in LG04 or Lighting Guide 04 from Sibse. And it says here, this is for the televised broadcast lighting. So lighting for television, it says here, the vertical illuminance is, there you go. Major events says it should be, let's zoom it, 1,400 lux, yes. And the camera minimum is 1,000 lux. With a uniformity of 0.6, this is for the camera. Main cameras, 1,400. Secondary cameras, 1,000. And this specific cameras is a 4%, or it's a percentage of the gradient. And for the national events, it's just 1,000 lux for the main cameras and 700 lux for the secondary cameras. For the second league events, that is only 700 lux. All right, so I think our project achieved the lux level requirements for camera number one because we got 100,600 lux. I love it. Look at that one. I hope you are feeling inspired now. To see more of this, visit www.enrocolightingdesign.com. See you there. And then let's check the other cameras. Say for example, for the futsal court, I did not activate it yet. Okay, let's go for the basketball still. We are focusing on the basketball. And say if I open the camera number two. Yes. And let's see what we have here. So I think we need to calculate. Okay, I need to calculate again. Okay, so it means you need to recalculate again the entire project to do it. So let's just do it. All right, so it is done. And what we got for camera number two for the basketball court is 1,292. Okay, so for the camera number two is 1,2. And it says in the standard, the secondary camera is 1,000 lux. So at least, still we achieve the lux value requirements. Perfect. And the uniformity is 0.6. The requirements is 0.6. That is so amazing. So Marcel, just go and recalculate every cameras so you will see the report. And I think this one is really looking good. And thank you so much for sending me this inquiry. I learned also a lot and I also discovered this Dialux evo. And yes, thank you so much. So for those of you who has this simple but amazing project, send it to me and so everybody can also learn by me posting it in YouTube. All right, so thank you so much. If you want to get this, no, I cannot share this LG04. It's a document. You can just check it in the Google or the internet, and also this one, this NBA camera locations. All right, so thank you so much and see you again on the next video. Don't forget my road lighting design course in Udemy is now open. Also, the Dialux evo Advanced. Go and check that one. All right, thank you so much and see you again in the next video.